When I come to this, what is this? From the zygomatic arch downwards, this is the muscle, the second muscle which is superficial. This is the vessel. And you know, this is the parotid gland, which is present below the auricle. And these superficial structures are the nerves coming from the parotid. They are the branches of facial nerve, together with the parotid, with the duct of parotid. This is the masseter. So, when we come to the superficial muscles of mastication, there are two. One above zygomatic arch and one below zygomatic arch. The one above zygomatic arch is with its fascia. And this is the masseter. Is it clear? Now, to go to the deep muscles of mastication, what will you do? Number one, we'll cut the zygomatic arch and take it out. And then we'll remove the masseter. As you know, the masseter is attached to the ramus of mandible. I will remove the ramus of mandible. As here. This is the site of zygomatic arch. I have cut it. Then the masseter comes out of zygomatic arch. I removed the masseter with it. And this is the mandible. Actually, this is the body of mandible. Here is the angle. And then there is the ramus. I have removed the ramus. Therefore, in this specimen, I have removed the arch, the muscle coming from the arch, and the ramus. And what will we see is this region. This is called the infratemporal fossa. In the infratemporal fossa, we have to see 5 spots. So the spots of today are 7. 2 superficial, which you have seen, temporalis and masseter, and 5D. What are the 5D? The 2 pterygoid muscles and 2 branches of mandibular nerve and maxillary artery. 2 pterygoids. 2 branches of mandibular and maxillary arteries. These are the 5. Number 1, you see this quadrangular muscle? All of you can see this quadrangular muscle? You see this quadrangular muscle? This is present in the upper part of the infratemporal fossa. This is the lateral pterygoid. So, everyone can see this muscle? All of you satisfied?
Yes.
This is the lateral pterygoid. The lateral pterygoid is like this. And if you look to this specimen, you will find another muscle like this. Medial to it, but taking the opposite direction. This is the medial pterygoid. Here is the medial pterygoid. Going to the angle of mandible. You see it? So what is this? And this? Is it clear? This is the lateral pterygoid, and this is the medial. So, between the two limbs of the forceps is medial. Is it clear? Is it clear?
Yes.
Okay. So, by now we have seen the 4 muscles. Here is the
temporalis.
And this is? And this muscle is?
Lateral
pterygoid, fleshy. And when you go to an aponeurotic muscle below it, and the medial pterygoid is directed towards the angle of mandible, the inner surface of the angle. Is it clear?
Yes.
We'll see them, then we'll discuss with each other.
Is it the neck of the mandible?
The neck of mandible is here. It has been removed with the mandible.
So where does the lateral pterygoid?
The lateral pterygoid, this is the lateral pterygoid, which is directed up towards the neck of mandible. This is a part of the neck of mandible.
Oh.
Understood? So now what is this? That and this? On the lateral pterygoid, there is an artery. You see this artery? This artery? Nothing is superficial to it except this artery. You see this artery, which is superficial to it? Giving many branches? Huh? This artery is the maxillary artery. Therefore, this muscle is lateral pterygoid. And superficial to it is
maxillary.
Deep to it is the mandibular nerve. When I ask you, give me the structure superficial to the mandibular nerve, it is the lateral. As you know, the mandibular nerve is formed of a trunk like this that divides into anterior and
posterior.
And the anterior give branches, and the posterior give branches. All of them are deep to lateral. Two of the branches will come down from deep to lateral pterygoid, as here. Two branches come down from deep to lateral pterygoid. One is anterior and one is
posterior.
Can you see them? I am catching now the posterior. And this is the anterior. This is the lingual nerve. And the one posterior is the inferior alveolar nerve. With the inferior alveolar nerve, you will find a branch from maxillary artery. Now I will pass it to you. Okay? Catch it in your hand. It is blastic. Okay? Blastinated. You will find the lateral pterygoid above with
maxillary
artery. You will find the medial pterygoid below and deep with two branches of mandibular, which are lingual and inferior. As with the inferior alveolar, there is a branch of maxillary artery which is called inferior alveolar artery. So again, the spots are seven. Two superficial, which are temporalis and masseter. And five deep. Two muscles, two nerves, one artery. The two muscles are lateral pterygoid above, medial pterygoid below. Lateral pterygoid is fleshy, medial pterygoid is aponeurotic. It's whitish. Okay. Superficial to the lateral pterygoid, there is maxillary artery. Superficial to medial pterygoid is maxillary, two branches of mandibular nerve, which are lingual and inferior alveolar. Lingual and? Can you see? I want to see the five spots, please.
The lingual is anterior?
The lingual anterior, the inferior alveolar posterior.